Shot from in front of the net, and the bar is directly over that line that you see. And we have some fog that has developed here. The Devils were actually waving towels at their bench to try to cause it to lift.
There's Mike Richards. He's trying to push Brodeur's arm into the net. That wouldn't be considered a goal. And I don't think it's conclusive, Doc. They've got to go with the call on the ice, which is no goal.
So we play on with a minute 46 to go in OT.
Oh, the smoke bomb.
Is that what it was?
Yeah.
Okay, I saw something hurled out of the seats, and it had a light at the end of it, but I didn't realize that's what it was.
Oh, yeah, right. I saw that flash through as well. Thought it was a falling star, and then I realized this isn't an outdoor game.
I should remember from my Halloween days, but I had forgotten clearly.
Oh, what a save by Marty Brodeur, though, to get the rib of his pad on the puck. And it looks like there's going to be a slight delay. It might also be a stink bomb as well as a smoke bomb. All the players are out on the ice milling around. Now, why would that be? They're looking. You know, Doc, it was right down below us that I saw the smoke bomb being thrown. So they're trying to locate the crazy individual who just did that. We may have a replay. Watch here. We've got a replay. Watch in the goal area here. It's going to come flying. Let's keep watching. Same area. Oh, there's the smoke. There's the smoke after it landed. But I saw, as you did, Doc, I saw it traveling through the air. And it had a flame behind it. And I couldn't figure out at the time what it was. And now we know. But, I don't know. You ever seen that before?
That's a new one. That's a new one. And hopefully that's the first and last of those that we'll see.
Mm-hmm.
Ornery stuff like this sometimes has a way of catching on, but hope not.
But you know what, Doug? Like, that's premeditated.
Yeah?
You know, who comes thinking, oh, this would be cool to throw a smoke bomb on the ice? I mean, I don't know if they caught the culprit. And I hate to say it's indicative of Philadelphia, but I guess no one would be surprised that it happened here first.
Brent Sutter is motioning to his players, I think, to skate around a little bit. Maybe that's what the circling motion with his hand is, just to try and cause some of that to lift.
Well, getting back to the game now, if the Devils do get to a shootout, the Flyers historically have been awful in the shootout, only 8 wins and 20 losses. So that's another thing, a minute 46 to go. And I don't know, Doc, if the players really know those kind of stats. You know, the advantage they might have statistically if they got to a shootout.
Let's hear from Steve downstairs.
Just to add, Doc Emmerich, that it is about as pungent as anything I've smelled in any arena in the time I've been with this crew. And the fog is very thick as you look from one end of the ice to the other, and I'm not so sure that this is going to get cleared up anytime in the next 60 seconds or so. The guys here were telling me it came immediately after it was ruled no goal, and it came from a section just over the penalty boxes, but you guys might have showed that picture already.
We saw it hurtling in the air. If it was indeed from the lower section, it had a lot of arc on it. It seemed to me like it might have been more from the upper tier, but that's quite a pitch that would take. But it looks as though they're going to resume the game here.
And you know what, Doc? We're starting to smell it up here a little bit. It's starting to rise, and yeah, you're right, Steve. It's very noticeable, but better up here than down on the ice, and now the play will resume.
The odor is certainly not indicative of this game. My goodness, it's been terrific. Richards is waved out. Gagne comes.